Today there is I will do it now an introduction, and then there will be a keynote from Patrizia Moschera as an overview on the situation on higher education, and then Amos Bianchi and Nicole Ottiger, and so we will have a coffee break, and we will finish with Paolo Luca Barbieri and Sara, Aviva Ramani and Massimiliano Dier. At the end of the day there will be a panel with Pierluigi, Antonio and Jeremy. And I suggest I invite Jill also, that yesterday we forgot. So I'm sorry, very sorry, because I was a little bit tired. So I can start with my presentation. I don't know if you want that someone shoot off the light, maybe. Or if we can see. Sorry? There is a panel. No, and. Okay. So I will speak about the experience that we had here in ABBA. I start with you know, what we did. So a brief introduction on where we are. That New Academy of Fine Arts, this is Nuova Accademia delle Arti, this is the meaning, is a full private academy that was founded in the 80s from a man called Ausonio Zappa and two artists very well known in Milano, Guido Ballo and Tito Varisco. And it was the first private academy of higher institution that received in the 81 the official recognition from the Italian Ministry of Public Education that now became the Ministry of Education, University and Research. And then it was bought by a private group, the Bastogi Group, and Integrated Futurarium, founded by Alessandro Guerriero, is one of the historical designer of Milano. You know, there is a big tradition of design in Milano. And we moved in 2004 in this campus in Via Carlo Darli. And in 2010, ABBA became part of an American property that is a fund, an American fund, that is the Laureate International University Network. And so now we are facing this new dimension, because we are part of this big, huge institution, and we are growing and growing with a lot of managers coming every day with the very important title like CEO, CTO, CTPO, FFO, SSO, and it's very interesting. But what is interesting from the NABA is that it was founded by a group of artists with a vocation for teaching, and we are. It was founded by Kim Girazuma, Emilio Sgro, Carlo Moi, Emilio Tanini. They are very well known here. Gianni Colombo, Lucio Del Pezzo, Franco Grignani. So it was a kind of alternative to the Statal Academy of Fine Arts, for the governmental one, that is Brera, one of the oldest in Europe. And in the 80s, there was the need of some institution that can provide a kind of new education. And in 1984, there was the first curriculum on design, graphic design, and in 1997, a bachelor on art degrees. But our experience is really focused on the bachelor in media design that was founded by me and Amos Bianchi in 2003. And in 2005, I and Roy asked, we founded the M-Node, using obviously the methodology of the Planetary Collegium. And in 2010, again with Amos Bianchi, we founded or we launched the MA in Film and New Media. And so what we did is the first Italian complete higher degree in new technology for art, because instead we call Film and New Media or Media Design institutionally inside the Ministry of Education and Research. The title is New Technology for Art. And the faculty is rooted on a series of theories of node or ideas. The postmodern theories, a cybernetic and theory of complexity, a McLuhan use of words as probes, philosophy of techniques. There is a really anti-specialistic vision, critical theory, the idea of space of flows and nodes, and academy as a lab of research. First of all, it is rooted in postmodern theories. Obviously, there are an enormous amount of postmodern thinker, but in my experience I found a very interesting meditation in Marshall McLuhan that from, I think gives us one of the best and interesting meditation on a postmodern society and knowledge, on François Lyotard in Félix Guattari, it's very similar to before in this photo, and on in the post-constructivism or radical constructivism of Ernest von Clausewitz, which one I'm really linked because we tried to do a movie on him before he passed away last year. Because I don't have so many time, I can go. Well, so there is the idea of cybernetic that, as you know, came from Gregory Mason, from Jacob von Buxkull, and arrived today to Ernest von Clausewitz. But what is really interesting is the idea of cybernetic like an homeostatic process. And I just put some visual ideas like the homeostatic valve, the first homeostatic valve, the one that is considered the most important in discovery or invention of the 20th century, that is the thermionic valve. And Roy Ascott, the one that developed a theory of cybernetic knowledge or better education. And obviously, because I am a scholar of Roy Ascott, I bring his ideas into the experience of all the faculty. So he's very famous, his ground course and his meditation on how everything is created or self-created by a group of apparatus that are the same students, the same teacher, and the context working all together.